Hello from API Video. Today I'm going to teach you how to use API Video's Python client with Flask and Dropzone.js, which is a really cool library that lets you drag and drop multiple files and upload them. There's a couple tricky things though about using it if you want to include form data. So specifically what we're going to go over today is how to add form data and files together in a drop zone and have it all get picked up and work together in the form. And so to get started, I'm just going to show you a quick little demo of what it will look like. So let's go ahead and run this. Okay, and I'm going to fire up our HTML page. So here I just have like the little form set up. This is the submit button for everything. You can take an API key here and then drop files. You would be able to add other data if you wanted, and if you don't want to use the API key this way, like it was going to be used with customers, you could do something with like delegated tokens, or it could be like, you know, not presented directly in the form. It's up to you, but this is just for today's walkthrough. So I'm going to go ahead and put the API key in, and then I'm going to grab a few files. So what's cool about this is you can do files of any size, even really big files. Chunked uploads are handled because we are using the Python client from API Video. So I'm doing one file that's 14.5 MB, and then here I'll do like a small one that's like, okay, wait, oops, let me get both. Okay, that, and then let's see, that. All right, so a few different sizes. I'm gonna say go ahead and open them. So they're all here, and they're just waiting for me to upload them. So now I'm just gonna click submit. Dropzone tells me it got started. Let's see what's going on in our terminal window. And now we're just gonna wait for those to finish uploading. There isn't a progress indicator on this example, so you'll just be waiting for a little while, especially if you chose bigger files. If you have like a huge file, I would give it more time. Okay, so you can see when it uploads, Dropzone.js gives us a little visual check mark saying like, okay, it uploaded. And then you can also check by, of course, going to your dashboard on API Video, refreshing, and it should show you your new videos. So I have my three videos, and one is still being processed, and that was the biggest of the three. So when it's done, you'll be able to see a thumbnail. All right. Now let's go over the code. So to set up the code, obviously you're gonna need an API Video trial account at least. You're probably gonna wanna grab the code from GitHub, and that's all in the description underneath this video. And you're also going to want to probably install a virtual environment. You don't have to, but it just makes it easier, like, and neater to keep your projects separate. And so once you've done that, we'll just get started in the index.html file first. So for this, we have the basic standard stuff up here. I'm adding the things I'm going to be using. There's a few ways to add Dropzone. You can add it using the CDN method, which is what I chose, and its dependencies. You can also add Dropzone by putting it in the static folder for Flask. You'd have to add a static folder and then just add the Dropzone files in there. So your choice. Under that, I have a script that we're going to be using for Dropzone, but we'll come back to that. I want to start with the form first. So I'm going to go down to the body here. And this is where we have the form. The really important part of the form is right here where I'm highlighting. So what we have here is just really basic. I'm telling it that when you're going to submit, send it, the action is to send it to the slash. That's the address I wanted to go to. And that information is important because we added class Dropzone, which basically tells Dropzone that this form is going to be a Dropzone. So once you do that, you have to tell Dropzone where you want to send the data in the form. And that's why the action is important. Otherwise, there's other ways to specify it, but I didn't choose that method. So then the next thing we're going to do is we're going to put the ID for our form, which in my case, I just chose my Dropzone. And then I'm saying that it's a multi-part slash form data, and the method is going to be post. And then I added a submit button because there's only one button of this type. You can just put button type submit, which is, well, that's what I chose to do. And then this is where I added the field for the API key. And you don't actually need anything else because we added this class, Dropzone already knows the whole thing is Dropzone. So now let's go up and take a look at the rest of this. So this is the style. So the style on the page that's completely customizable. I did something really simple. So this is the basics I put for the Dropzone with the border and everything. And then this is like the key part right here. This is where we set options for Dropzone. So by default, Dropzone wants to upload your files immediately. The second you let go of the file over the Dropzone, it's going to try to upload it to wherever. And we need an API key, so we don't want to do that. And there also might be cases where you want it to like wait until you have, you know, your whole batch of files together or something like that. So we're setting this up for my Dropzone. You can see that it's in camel case. That's just actually how you're going to translate it. So in the form, it was my-dropzone. And so then when we write it as part of the options, we're going to say camel case version. And then now just walking through really quick, it says auto process queue. We say false because we don't want it to start uploading right away. We want it to wait until we're ready. We want it to be able to handle multiple files, so we say true for that. Parallel uploads, we say up to 10, and max files up to 10. Be careful with this because you can definitely have like way too many files, and then it'll take a really long time, and it's probably not a fun wait or a good experience. Timeout is changed here because by default, Dropzone waits 30 seconds and then just times out, and Flask is actually still working. It'll keep working on uploading your files, but Dropzone's just decided, oh, I didn't hear back yet. So, I guess it didn't work. And you'll get an error, like a visual display saying it didn't upload, but it's actually still uploading. So if you want to avoid that, change the timeout, which is in milliseconds, to be 2,700,000 or some other really big number. I chose this because that's like a 45-minute timeout, which... that way, if I want to upload big files, which I did for one of my tests, it's going to be fine. Now we're just basically adding an event listener to our submit button. It's basically saying wait, and once we have everything together and you click this button, go ahead and have Dropzone process all the files. So that's everything for this page. Let's go over to the app. Page. So app page, this is based on Miguel Grinberg's work, so like you probably recognize some of the structure here. I'm not going to get too into all the details because he has a great tutorial and I will reference it in the description so you can see that. But here's some of the basics here, like we're adding API video and we're adding the video's API endpoint like in the import statements using OS and then a few things from Flask. The app config max content length, that's a way where you can prevent people from uploading something too big. So I wanted to test it for large files, so I made this really big, but you could make it a lot smaller. Upload extensions, that's just a way to limit people uploading things either that they shouldn't be, so they're not like, hey, why didn't it upload, or to prevent like someone who's trying to upload like an exe file. So this is just video formats I'm saying we can take. And then we have the error handler. We're probably not going to get file is too large, but if you made your max content length smaller, you'd probably get this error at some point. This route right here is basically telling us like when you start up, open the index.html page and show us the form. And then this here is how files will be uploaded. So the first thing that happens is when the data comes in from the form, it's actually in a file storage object, and you have to get the information out, and it's separated. So the files data is in dot files, and the form data is in dot form. And so the easiest thing is just to grab all the files and assign it, and then grab whatever you needed out of the form data. So that's what I'm doing here. And then I'm just looping through everything in my files. And here I'm just, this was also Miguel Greenberg's tutorial. So it's checking that you actually uploaded something and it's not empty or something like that. If it is, you get an error saying like, hey, this isn't right. And then we're setting up the API video client and connecting. And so once we do that, we're going through the basic upload a video process, which I went through in a previous tutorial really quickly with API video. If you are using access tokens, when you upload a video, you have to create a container first, and then the container can have a little bit of metadata like title, description, whatever, and then you upload your video into the container with another call. So that's kind of what we're doing here. We're setting up the container, we're grabbing the video ID so we can access that container, and then we're saying, go ahead and take the file that we have from Dropzone, open it as a stream, and start sending it. And so doing it this way means that it can handle like a big or a small file. So you might have seen this handled differently in some of my other samples. So then because we didn't add a progress listener to this example, you're just gonna wait for a bit and it should upload. And then when you're done, you can go check in the dashboard. And that's everything for uploading videos using Dropzone and Flask. Thanks for listening today, and I'll see you next time. Bye.